Black media has become the biggest threat to the black community outside of black murderers. Black murderers are worse than absentee fathers because black murderers are the reason that some kids grow up without fathers. But unfortunately, in the black community, we celebrate the criminal class. Matter of fact, you're not even considered really black unless you come from a violent place. They respect you less if you come from prosperity. If you come from a two-parent household, then you're looked down upon. If you come from the ghetto and a place where black people are killed, you're respected more. How so, Sway? I don't know. Now, there is something called the Victim Olympics. There are content creators and there's black media that go out of their way to ignore the positive things that are happening in the black community so they continue to promote the dysfunction of the black community and so they can evade accountability for why their life, their romantic and family life is in shambles. We'll celebrate people like Nick Cannon for some reason. Nick Cannon is just a nicer version of Future. These baby daddy types that have multiple kids, I don't know why they're praised and celebrated. I don't know why we uplift Nick Cannon. Nick Cannon is no different from Future. Just because he gets along with his children's mothers makes him no different. He is creating broken homes and is being celebrated for destroying multiple lives of families. Not only that, they're allowing him to be the face of what a good dad is. That's a slap in the face to all of us men who are there every day. We don't have time to create different families. You have so many shows and this and that. There's no way you can be a dad that's worth a damn. It's an embarrassment. Now, we celebrate people like Nick Cannon. We celebrate women like Erykah Badu that has all of these baby daddies all across the span and don't see anything wrong with it. And then wonder why the men that do work and sacrifice, why we don't want to have nothing to do with this faulty media who's perpetuating the narrative that, you know, that we ain't nothing. It's the CDC said that African-American dads are some of the most involved dads, even when they're not even when they don't have custody. It's nonsensical. All of these things in African-American community that go against the facts. As of last year, 57% of African-American men are middle class. The majority of single moms are in poverty. But yet, we are celebrating the dysfunction and we're ignoring the men that are paving the way. It makes no sense. It makes no sense. Now, on top of that, I don't see Fox News with all of these man-hating content creators, Fox Soul and The View and The Real. They never talk about the stats about the positive things that African-American men are doing. All they want to do is talk about the dysfunctional, cheater, no job having people, even though 57% of African-American males are doing well. Only 38% of African-Americans in the 1960s were middle class, but simultaneously, less than 10% of the African-American children experienced poverty in the 60s. Now that black men are 57% middle class and that black women and women in general are making advances and making more money, childhood poverty has increased. How could childhood poverty increase as black wealth is also increasing? I don't know. I guess that's something that the black community has to figure out.